You may have noticed a breath of fresh air is blowing over the Atlas Copco factory floor. A breath of lean air.
Lean manufacturing is about the elimination of waste. We really concentrate to the tasks which are giving added value to the product. We eliminate all other tasks which are not giving added value, like walking, waiting time, bad quality, and so on.
The new assembly lines look very different compared to the old ones.
The previous assembly lines we designed in a totally different way. We looked to the compressor, we looked to all the material which was needed to assemble all types of compressors, and we put it into the assembly line.
In the old way of thinking, operators were literally surrounded by mountains of components.
They had all the components in the small blue boxes in front of them, and they had to choose the right component. And sometimes operators are mistaken and taking the wrong component, and it leads to waste.
Those days are coming to an end.
Now we look to the operator and we look to the tasks of the operator. And instead of having all material on the assembly line, we bring the material to the operator in direct access to the operator.
On a lean line, the operator is the center of things.
We bring all the material in sequence to the line, so the first component on the line is also the component he needs for the machine he is working on. Quality is, of course, always our first concern. It's therefore we introduced the tools like Poka-Yoke plates. The aim of the Poka-Yoke plate is that they start up at the beginning of the assembly with filling up this plate, and at the end of the assembly, the plate must be empty.
The lean concept makes life and work easier for the operators. For instance, all carriers are on wheels. This also makes it easier to quickly adapt the line to changing production needs. Modern electrical tools are at hand. These ensure that the perfect amount of torque is applied and that all necessary screws are used. And a barcode-based traceability system guarantees that all the right components are installed in each unit.
We really focused on the design for assembly. We also looked to the way of working for the operator, so that the operator has an easy access to all the components, that he can easily assemble the components into the unit.
Another aspect of lean manufacturing is to strive for less components.
Try to standardize as much as possible. We try to have the same components as much as possible for the different types of compressors. By focusing on standardization, we're also able to reduce the total assembly time.
As a result of the shorter assembly time, the throughput time is shortened as well. Lean manufacturing is essential in ensuring accurate delivery times for high volume production. Not only the assembly time was shortened, so was the assembly line.
This assembly line is much, much shorter than a classical assembly line. For example, when we first designed this assembly line, not according to the lean principles, we had an assembly line of 17 meters. Today, this production line is only 14 meters, and this is only by implementing lean principles, like sequencing, bringing material to the operator, and designing the workstation according to the needs of the operators and not according to the needs of the compressor anymore.
A lean environment and product design both tailored to the needs of the operator. Less components, meaning less room for error. Lean manufacturing is the way forward. In fact, the first results of lean manufacturing in the portable energy division have proven this point. On-time delivery increased by 15% and quality improved by 11%. A resounding success.
By implementing the principles of lean manufacturing, we reduced the total amount of components, we reduced the working time, and by doing so, we were able to reduce the amount of workstations. And we were even able to improve the quality, so it's a win-win situation.